Thank you very much.
Now I'm going to introduce Hardik sir. Hardik sir, Professor Hardik Vala, Assistant Professor of Silborgh University. Now we are going to present Design Thinking Process webinar title, and agenda is basic process and framework of design thinking and relevant tools and techniques for creativity and innovative ideas. Now we
Okay,
can.
thank you very much, sir.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, my voice is clear. Hello. Yes, my voice is
It is
clear,
audible, sir.
everyone. Okay, thank you very much, Sujit sir. Okay, myself, department from Silver Oak University, Ahmedabad, welcomes you and thank you, Paras Institute of Engineering and Technology, to give the platform for giving and sharing the idea regarding the design thinking and process and the tools and techniques and the methods which are being used for design thinking and process. Okay, so everyone welcome, all the students and the participants and faculty members. As the topic of our today is regarding the design thinking and process. So basically, this design thinking and process is being used in each and every field of the engineering, not just only for the aeronautical purpose, but it can be used for the any engineering if you want to apply this design thinking and process. So today, basically, there are numbers of tools and techniques and methods in which we can use this different methodology, and through which we can use this for giving out a new product or something which is a reliable product that can be converted into the usable product again. Okay, sir, it is okay with English, or I can go with multi language like Hindi and both.
Sir, we can do any language, no problem.
Okay, so I will like to go with a multi language. Somewhere I will use the Hindi as well as the English both, so it will be visible to everyone. Okay, so basically, what will be the design thinking that's being used? So we will see the conceptual needs, why we require this thing, what is the basic concept behind the design thinking process which we need to cover up. Thinking, design thinking introduction. So first thing is why we require this conceptual need, that why we require this design thinking, and then after we will start with the design thinking introduction, that what we can do inside this design thinking process, what are the different tools and methodology which we can apply to that, and through which we can use a new tools and design and methodology. And lastly, the importance and social economic relevance, that through this design thinking, what we can change in the social economical relevance. That might be a small change, but that impact this total social and economical product which will be designed by using the design thinking methodology. Okay, and another last topic in this we will cover is about the biomimic that is being used from the concept of design thinking only. So now coming with our first, that is the Indian approach to the global context on the design thinking process. So in the parliament way back a decade, the president had declared that in next 10 years, and again that is already gone, it's been decade of the innovation, that you all might know that, okay, that this two one decade and still coming on the decade will be the decade of the innovation, as we are now suffering from the pandemic of corona. Okay, in that also we are getting a new innovation and ideas, and that has been coming, and through that we are getting a startup and all that. So that was earlier only it was decided in the parliament that, okay, this will be the decade which will be going to be the decade of the innovation. So also by US President Barack Obama said that education and the innovation will be the currency for the 21st century. So you can see that who will get the particular education in that particular field, and according to that he or she will be producing some innovation. Okay, through that only he or she will get the currency, or you can say a good living. Okay, so you can see that, like for example of different like a big companies like SpaceX, where it was and now in one decade where it is right now. So this is what already said by the president. So I have all the content or all the things which is being given by the somewhere or somewhere it has been taken. Okay, it is not by me. Okay, so this is all the content whichever I have taken that will be given lastly at the reference. So continue global innovation lead summit in San Francisco also been said that collectively in a Norway also proposed for the Nobel Prize for the innovation also in the I-20 summit also. So those who are getting any innovation like content will be also given a Nobel Prize on that. So India, as we know that having the largest youth, okay, with her age between 10 to 24, okay, which has smaller than the China. So this will play one of the important role. Then we have China and Indonesia. Okay, so like around 356 million youth, which are 65%, which are pursuing higher educations in different universities. Okay, as our Prime Minister Narendra Modi also said about the Making India vision. So this is how the design think before starting the design thinking, what we are standing right now. It was around few decades back, it is already decided that, okay, how we can use our own technology, own methodology, our own people use that and create a new idea out of which they can earn. So you can see the lots of different ideas and innovation is coming out, and lots of startups has been given promotion, okay, through the Make in India scheme. So this how thinkers need to do it. So we need to transfer that thinking. Okay, you are thinking somewhat if this is feasible or not feasible. So for this thing here, the main content is the thinkers to the doers, that okay, you what you are thinking and how you are going to do that, or you are going to perform. Okay, so that is the main content. So here are the some of the Indian higher education statistic. That has been taken by UGC, that has been prepared. So all over we have around 700 institutes awarding degree, affiliated college, different types of field, arts, engineering, science and commerce. Okay, so according to that, what we can start and what we can do in the thinking process. Okay, so there are number of institutions which has been providing such platform for doing this thing under the skill development of India. Okay, so what will be the structure through which we can use this process, or what would be the thing which can be used through this design thinking process? So the required one is the skill, a proper curriculum and a culture. According to why it has been required, or why these three things is required, because skill, according to the skill, we can say that okay, need to identify a individual person wise skill, that okay, some people are good at something, some are at another. According to that, the curriculum and the culture part is the one of the important impact, because at different region different cultures are following, different things are following. So according to that, they will develop more skill. So on that basis, the design based learning process need to be develop, or you can say a particular all integration of this skill, curriculum and culture is being introduced inside this design basic based learning process. So for that we required collaboration of all the things. What we required the collaboration of all the things is universities. Okay, different universities need to collaborate with the students. Then also the faculty members also need to be involved in that. For that, then industries also one of the important criteria. Then society in which we are living, according to that, because at cultural wise and region wise there will be a different types of societies being there. So all need to become with and the last but not the least, the government also play a important role to bring all this thing together. Okay, so we need to be working together to from thinkers to the doers. All this need to be work according to the collaboration means. Okay, so collaboration is required by all the. So one, how one means? So somewhat faculty or society or industries are connected with each other, or students might connected with the societies and what happening. So government are connected with the universities and through which they can help the faculties and students. So likewise, the collaboration is one of the important criteria for this type of design thinking process and involvement. Okay. Now, why the conceptual needs required for that? Okay. So design thinking mindset need to be of students and faculty members. So here, if I give some of the example, if you are doing some of the projects work or like, so you come with directly with your ideas and your topics like that for XYZ topics. This is our idea or I like that. But here in the design thinking mindset is little bit different. Here you have to keep or keep one domain. Okay, as you are the aeronautical students, so you have to keep at a particular one domain for the aerospace engineering or aeronautical thing. So if you keep that particular one domain, out of which you can put any one of the domain, like there are number of domain design, then we have the engine section, we have the structure section, we have the management section, we have the transport section, we have the drone section or UAV section, and then aerial vehicle section. So according to that, first you have to go for the particular domain. Okay, so in which domain? So that's why here it comes the particular skill that, okay, this XYZ student is required this skill. He is very good at this skill. So he will get that particular domain. And then after he will start working on that particular domain, then only it will start. Like in project, what we do that, okay, we directly go for that particular topic. Okay, this is this and that what we need to do. And like not here, it is somewhat little bit reversible like thing, that you have to first go for a particular domain and then after you see all the possibilities that we will see later on how it is work. Then the problem solving skill is required. That means that what types of problems are involving inside that particular system, like that if you have to take a topic of that particular domain, so you are good at that particular topic or particular skill. So by default, you will start getting solving that particular problem easily. So that's why again, it's come the skill. Then converts this idea into solution and the project into the product. That is the one of the important criteria here. Okay, you got the idea and all the things, and you also try all the solutions and possible. But the main thing is that our projects which are being used, or it is getting ideas, are not converting into the product, or you can say the final product which we required is been not converting. So here the design thinking methodology will help this, through which you can convert your project into the product. Integrated design mindset with the engineering learning skills. So here design as well as meeting of the engineering learning skills are required. Reducing the copy paste project, which we mostly do. Okay, so by this mean we will reduce the copy paste project types also. So this is the one of the great platform of design thinking, through which help you can reduce the copy paste project and you will make your own skill and develop and also your own work. So learning by doing this. So here are the some of the skill which is being given. So hand-on building skill, then a practical approach will be there. Okay, so now there is a 21st century skill which is required for any design thinking process or required. So first is the we divide into three sections. One is the foundational literacy, that how students are applying core skill on everyday tasks. Then competency, which is outside the world, which is required for the competency, complex challenge. And what are the qualities or characteristics should require by the student approach to the change the environment? So here are these 16 skills which must possess. You can learn lifelong to be a good engineer or a good person in the particular field. So literacy, that means numerically, scientifically, ICT, that is electronically, or you can say intelligent computer technology based, finance literacy, and cultural and civic literacy. This all literacy amongst the thing, that how you learn the thing, how analytically you are good, how scientifically you are good, how computerly, that is how physically you can use the computer system and their working, then financially you able to know the condition and what is the culture and the civic things inside them. Then the computational things, that is the thinking creatively, okay. Then communication skills are should be one of the that, and collaboration with the another thing, or you can say collaboration with the other person should be there. Then another is the characteristics, that how curiosity, initiative, adaptability to that particular thing. Then you might have some leadership or like social and cultural awareness you might have. So this is the what 21st century skill, not just what you learn in your engineering is the thing which is required. That is the earlier skill. These are the six things which was the foundation of the literacy, which is earlier required. But another than that, these 10 things should be there nowadays to be having a good quality engineer for that. Okay. So starting with our what is a design thinking. Okay. Now we come to the design thinking process and what is design thinking methodology. So as the conversational term, particular thinking part, it's not just a decision making, it's more than that. Okay. It's like a miracle. So like Mo Smith, innovation is miracle. So earlier it was like, say, okay, this is what happening. Earlier also in our Rigveda and Ayurveda, we have seen that earlier only we have developed that, okay, there are some planets, sun is the center and earth is below it. That we have already done. But someone like other things are things like that, it's our myths. Okay, that believe that it is like we can say ki jadoo hai kuch, but not just a innovation thing. Especially gift one must know that individual should know that thing. Okay, so on that myths, innovation is regarding myths and reality. That what is myths and what is reality. So innovation brings with a creativity. How you are creative, how you know the things. Innovation beginning with a curiosity. Also, that how curious about your particular field or a particular topic. Innovation is smooth linear process. We need to go with that particular process only then, and then after you will be able to get some innovation. See, innovation is like, not like that you will have something new thing, or you will develop something new. It's like if there is any existing thing only, in that also if you make something change, that is also a somewhat innovation. But for that innovation, you required a particular methodology or particular thinking process through which you can change that particular thing like that. So these are the some of the innovation myths and reality. Innovation is iterative and outcome of series of experiment. That means you have to do again and again, repeatably, again and again, repeatably things. That okay, you are not getting the perfect condition, so iteration is required. So series of experiment is required for a single small innovation inside the any one of the product. So it's like for example, I will give, earlier we have used the supercomputers, then we come to the desktop, then we come to the laptops, then we come to the mobile processor. So this is how the design thinking process comes. Okay, that okay, this is how if I can, all the computer thing can become inside the mobile. So this is the iterative process which need to be involved. Okay, also about taking risk, how you take the involvement of the risk and its mitigation is required. So design thinking, we believe that rather waiting for most or genius comes to and have some innovation which you have should be bring. So through the design thinking, we can build a bridge across the new land of promising future and reliable manufacturing by our own miracle. Okay, so this is a design thinking is nothing but a particular one bridge which covers the doers to the thinkers to the doers. Okay, it's a gives just a platform or a particular platform to the people or to the students between the gap between the thinkers and the doers. Okay, so beside that, we will see one video, 1 minute of that. So just 1 minute. Okay, is visible? Video is visible?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay. Thank you. So this is a one of the criteria for design thinking, which has been shown in a video that how you can change the process, or you can say there was an experiment which was being taken into the consideration, from which how the creative thinking can be changed. So this experiment was carried out around 6 months. So it takes some time, but it will be very good. Valuable. Okay, so I'm just sharing the PPT again. 1 minute. Okay, so I think you can see here. So what does thinking and design thinking innovation solution can be applied to the any field, including the higher education, and the approach of channel should be of a point of view at the end of the user. And the last but the least, understanding the user emotional needs, that what the particular user is required for the needs, what is the source of the needs for that particular thinking process. A mindset, that is human mindset, should be a centric, that is empathic. We will see that what is empathization or empathy. Okay, then collaborative, possibility of driving. Right, so collaboration of working, how it can be done. So what are the possibilities that can be done? And optimics, or you can say for the option focus, different way of finding the particular solution. Okay, not just a one particular thing. And last, experimental, which will be iterative, that it might be repeatedly you will getting same thing, but at one change you will might getting a new thing. So that is the experimental thing, or you can say a iterative thing. So in short, the design thinking is confidence that a new better thing are possible and that you can make them happen in that thing. Okay, so once a CEO of IDEO in Brown said that design thinking is human centered approach of innovation that draws design toolkit to integrate new needs of people and possibility of a new technology and requirement of the new business success model. Okay, that was been defined by this Tim Brown, who is the president and CEO of IDEO. Okay, if you go, you can search on this page, you can will get the idea. So approach is how you can see design thinking approach people desirability. Okay, in which it involves emotional innovation like branding, material, relationship. Then we have technology, that is the functional innovative things which is required between both people and technology, that is the feasibility process which you will use in the technology which has been shown. And lastly, the business, that is viability, how you are using that, or you can investing or taking the risk. And what comes out the enter in the center, it will be about the experimental or innovation idea will be generating or through this. Okay, so this is how the approach of design thinking been work with people, technology and business. Okay, so what are the requirement thing which has been shown here? So it can be divided into the two phases. Okay, first phase will be coming of the observation. So whatever the domain you are taking over here, you can need to be observed. You need to be observed that particular domain. Then that observation comes with the empathy. So we will see what is empathizing or empathy is one of the important criteria which is required in the design thinking. Okay, after empathizing, it will go through the ideation. Okay, that through the empathizing, what idea will be generating. And then a last another thing is the product development. According to that, the ideation, the product will be developed. So basically, repetition of observation thing. So here two side arrows are shown, not only one side arrow, two side arrows are shown. So it has been empathize. Okay, then again you can go for the observation, again you can come for empathize. After that you will get some idea, again you can go for the empathization. Through idea will generate one product or one system like that. Again, you get some another idea, you can go there, another product will be developed. Okay, then a prototype, and a test, and again you go for the observation for that test. So it will be a repeatability, and it's which a human centric approach is been required. Okay, so this is the problem zone where you will get some of the problem. Do not need to decide any problem from starting phase. You have to first select the particular domain inside, and then after you start this process, this tool mechanism, first you observe that particular thing repeatably, observation, take down the notes on that, then you put that into the emphasizing phase. Through that you will get some idea. Okay, so this is the problem zone and this is the solution zone out of which you will get. So this is what some this is the tool which has been used for the design thinking or in design process in which is been used. So everything has its own different individual aspect of observation, empathy, ideation, product development, prototype, and its testing. So that's why what we are saying, that the project which we are doing need to be come into the final test or a product test. Okay, so detailed design thinking process with tools and technique. So domain identification, what I am saying, that okay, introduced with a domain identification, what you select your particular any XYZ domain, then after you go for the observation of that particular domain. Inside that you can use a mind map technique, which is another thing, thinking tool which you can introduce here, through which you get the empathy and you define a design problem inside that. Then again you continue with that particular ideation through which a design problem or empathy through which you are getting. Okay, then you finalize or conceptualize that particular thing, and you do a dirty mock-up or particular prototype inside that, and you will finally produce one product or rough type product. And then again that product need to be given by the customer feedback, how it's approached towards the your product. Then after, it's ergonomic and aesthetic look, that how it's look, it is looking good or not, ergonomic wise it is good or not, that it is feasible to everyone or not. Then again, if it's there is any change, then we'll go for a pre-design, again detailed design, CAD modeling, prototype, final model, tense analysis, and optional other things. So this is the whole process you need to follow, which is been given by the design thinking tool. So what theoretically says, this is what the theoretically zone, you can see problem zone and solution zone, through which this what I have shown earlier, this all are theoretically which is been processed. This design thinking tool process is what theoretically or step by step tools technique which is you can follow. Okay, but the real process you can see here, it goes anywhere like that: brainstorming, prototype, defining the problem, testing, learning. So it is like somewhat like this. If you go like this, it will be coming, output will be this only, that's for sure. Now the main thing which we are talking about here is the empathy or empathizing. What is, so in design thinking, this is the one of the important criteria of empathy. So we will see the one video regarding the empathy here, just wait. I am just playing one again. So this is also one of the important criteria for the empathy. Okay, so from the video, I think you got the idea about how the empathy works, importance inside the design thinking. So what prospect of mind you are thinking about, that particular prospect of mind you need to think, you need to realize the particular product XYZ anything, you then after you can go ahead. So here are the some of the examples. You can see the pain of others through which you can design a particular cart, a particular stool, how you can see adjustable stool for staring up. Okay, so this is what the empathy. Okay, so great idea comes from the heart, not from the brains. Okay, so how the other will feel if you place that particular, you place it in your prospect in that particular, then you will able to get the idea. So here from the reference which I have taken from. Okay, so how to build the empathy? So just not enough. See, you all are looking that, okay, they are carrying the things, searching for water, stay gazing. Okay, so need to solve their problem, you need to empathize the people. Okay, so start social engineering principle over here. See the application through which you can use. Okay, so how to build? So here the civil engineer produce per year a still even affordable drinking water supply to urban area. Okay, so they are still using this type of thing to carry out the water to their home. So still there are no empathizing been created towards these people, that how challenged it. There is a small thing which need to be changed, to which this design thinking tools can be helpful. So on that there was an innovation that has been taken into the consideration. Take away your own pain, considering like that they have developed a water wheel. Okay, here is the example that is created by CNET Koiji. Okay, so you can carry a number of water very easily and very feasible. So see the thinking idea or just a thinking innovation very much useful. It is very small thing, but very much useful for others. Okay, so this is how the design thinking works. Okay, there is a no new thing or new creation. It has been how the empathy is been used. Okay, on that so there are innovation that is not always involve some technology hi-fi which has been used not been used that much. So wash basin used for flush tank can use many of water saving. Okay, so flush tank water can be used, what is being used from flush tank. This is what automation of chair you do when you sit. Okay, so from falling it can be used. So this is not about the high technology which can be used everywhere. So some small innovation and idea can be also be changed. Okay, it might be the cost, not the higher cost. If you keep a war tea or any mug, if you flow, then what happens? Some droplets of that tea or milk will go down, but it will stay here. It will not damage your table or life. So this is what some innovation, idea and technique. So what we call here, to carry a 6 cup in one only. So this is what innovation or small ideas can change the prospect. So for that you have to have empathize and you have to look at the system again and again and repeat it. So that so depends on the empathy user, how it is been using. Okay, so on this I have some video on that. Just wait, I will show you. Just 1 minute, I will share. There is a book, Nature, Furniture Hidden Book video, you will see that. So this was the particular one of the example through which a design thinking process, so from nature or from the thing, he from book, he has converted into the furniture. So there you can use everywhere. So it's a very much small thing, but it is very much effective. I think you will see on another video for the same thing. There is an mobile filtration vehicle. Just wait. So some of might have also seen the video somewhere or somewhere not. So this is what a design thinking can change one prospect mind, that how you can carry a water without any wastage of fuel, will get exercise and also get a pure drinking water through the design thinking process. So you can see that where at the video last end, that some of them help make changing in design. They started with somewhat changes, and then after the final product was designed. So CAD design was shown, and another I think we have the last two videos for same empathizing and I design. Last one video for this, I'll just show it. Just wait. So this one is very much interesting. You might have also seen somewhere or not, I don't know, but it is one of the interesting innovation you might have been seeing. Very simple but very effective. So here's the case study of how to decrease the use of accelerator, that is automatic staircase in the Sweden, Stockholm. So they have given one of the experimental video here, how they can increase the staircase use. See the change of mind of prospect of person. So through this, they have generated more than 66% for using the staircase over the accelerator. So this is how a design thinking process, or you can see the prospect view of empathizing the people, which you can see. Okay. Now we will just see the as the time limits. A biomimic, that through the nature how we can learn some of the things. Okay, so I think we have some time left. So design by nature, biomimic. You might have some idea about. So what is that? So as the new began era, the biggest innovation for 21st century will be invited by the biological and technological, that should be inspired by the nature. Okay, so you can see the mother nature having one of the universe most incredible design. So we are using it, having a problem of traffic where here zero non-stop traffic hour has been going in the, you can see an ant using a proper lane and using without any merge. So by using this thing, we can avoid the some thinking process applying through this. You can use our thousands of hours, which we can stop in traffic. Okay, right now we have a pad due to corona, we are at home. So at once it will believe there will be a problem, huge problem of traffic. So how to come with that solution? Here's one of the thinking process, and another is the. So biomimic is a human, a very clever without intent of to help creative machine sustain the problem of future generation. That is, how can find out the solution globally around us by the nature. Crosspoint. So here are the some of the high sky which is being used. Okay, so 20% of the world annually energy used to keep this structure with 1 degree Celsius. So we use ACs and all these things, but this fossil fuel required to keep this structure 1 degree lesser. Okay, so this ant meat things you can see they are also living but having a more cooling place than which we are using here. So through this example of biomaking around us, like Velcro, aeroplane, solar plane, ivory, building model after turmeric modes that we have seen. Okay, so this is what animal plant crops nowadays which we are using. Okay, they have found what works, what is appropriate, and most important, what lasts for here on the earth on that notes. So the creation of Velcro that we are using day by day, which is used day by, so that has been also been get idea from the switch engineer found from the dog fur. So these are the thing which has been made. So another thing is the mosquito bite. So nowadays material research engineering of Kassan University amazing potential of structure of potential of the mosquito mouse. That is, if you any mosquito bite, you don't feel, afterwards only you will feel. So they are using the painless needles, starting to develop a painless needle. If you insert a needle, you will not get any pain. Okay, so they are getting idea from the mosquitoes also. Okay, so this is what an impeller, you know the impeller thing in aeronautical. So this is Jay Hamer, founder of Parex Scientist, design a fan or in shape of hurricane created from the calla lily. So this from design, he has taken a design, and this is how you can use the impeller design and what effectively it makes work from the commercial base. So there is a one case study related to the East Gate building office complex of Harare in Zimbabwe. So from termite mound may not look impressive, but actual help. So there is an architecture which used to develop that type of building principle in Africa terminal mound. So it does not require conventional heating or air conditioning. Okay, so generally say termites are destroy building, but not through this design helping, it will keep the temperature and almost 3 degree lesser to the outside degree. So operational building will also use 40% of energy will be less. Okay, so it will save around air conditioning cost of 3.5 billion. So how you can see the East Gate building of office complex as Zimbabwe has air conditioning systems modulated from self-cooling modes. So this from this idea they have designed such a way that it will keep the building cool more, so less use of air conditioning, so less of heat wasted, through which efficiency is increased. So all this taken from by design by nature book. Okay, reference which I have taken from this, which has been shown here. Okay, so thank you very much for the patience and listening to me. I hope you have enjoyed and learned something of this design thinking and methodology. So if you have any question or any doubt, sir, they can ask student.
Yeah, thank you, sir. One of the question is on the behalf of a student, what are major companies that use design thinking internally?
Sorry, which the nature?
What are the major companies that use design thinking internally?
See, the big companies, see, for example, Google, they are using the design thinking process. The tools or the thinking process might be different, but through big companies like Accenture is there, our thing like our Airbus is there, or Boeing, they are having a particular one team in which they are having like this design thinking process or like design thinking center through which they are making a new thing. So there are many companies, not one companies, but many international companies are using this, like Apple also using this type of technique. See, design thinking having a number of different types of tools. It does not have any one tool. So they are using a different tools and methodology in the company which suits them best. Okay, I hope you got the answer.
Right, sir. Okay, one of the questions next. What are some ways that I can improve my design thinking skill?
See, the basic design thinking skill you need to improve is with the help of your empathizing and observation thing. If you are a good observer, okay, if you are in your society, if you see any garbage is standing or coming, and if you see regularly, I'm just giving the example, through different mechanism you can change your design thinking, which I have already discussed, like empathizing the people. You have to place yourself in that particular position. For example, from your home, some people are taking their garbage. What are their situations? Where they are living? How they use their garbage system? Okay, if they are properly maintained or not? Their health is properly maintained or not? So you have to place yourself in that position. Okay, so through the empathizing and through the observing repeatedly, you can change your design thinking process. And another, as an engineer, you need to think like a innovation or particular your application of that ideas, or you can say technology in that process. Okay, so I think
right. Next last question is, how to design thinking and innovative related to each others?
Can you repeat, sir?
Design thinking and innovation related to each other. How?
Design thinking and innovation related to each other. As I have seen many of you example, okay, that from there many of the videos also. See, the innovation is what you can come from the design thinking. It might be a small innovation, like you have seen the water recycling or water purification. Right now, which we are using in ROs, many of the villages are still having a shortage of water, through which they are changing, through this. So this is what design thinking help to generate the innovation idea, or you can say to generate the, or you can say to make the innovation thing. Okay, through this only you can create an innovation idea. I think you got the idea, right?
Right.
So any other questions?
Sir. No, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for giving the webinar.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. So I hope everyone has enjoyed, and thank you for respecting, getting a view and giving ideas regarding the design thinking. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay. Welcome. Welcome. Okay. So we can end the session.
Yes.
Okay.
See you.